Where's my AA people at? It's the first fucking rule. Don't tell anybody. What are you doing? You blew it. First rule of Fight Club is you don't talk about Fight Club. Where's my NA people at? NA people? Couple, yeah? Where's my NA people that go to AA meetings because they think everybody in NA looks like they're going to steal your stereo? Yeah, I know you're sly games, you people. It's like, I'm not going to NA. Those people are scary. It's like, you're that person. That's all right. I love you guys all. Who's ever been kicked out of this comedy club for being too drunk in here? Yeah, I knew it. I knew it. I was sending out flyers outside the Alano Club, and some dude was like, oh, jeez. Last time I was in this place, I got kicked out. Turn over a new leaf, buddy. Come on. Building bridges here. Oh, man. I'm excited to be here. I'm excited just to be anywhere. You guys are good fun. First of all, I'd like to thank my official sponsor, Old Navy. Yeah? It's pretty great, right? I feel like if Old Navy had like a NASCAR team, it would just be guys wearing this with helmets on, you know? Just a flame-retarded version of this. Kind of mad at Old Navy right now, though. I found something kind of screwed up at Old Navy recently. Yeah, they turned on me, those bastards. They sell at Old Navy a 3XL slim fit shirt. That's a real thing. Think about it. Let it sink in. I wear a 3XL shirt and never once have been like, God, I wish this shirt fit a little slimmer, you know? Let's get rid of all this material here in the ribs. What do I need this for? Me in a 3XL slim fit shirt's like trying to get that Coleman tent you got back in the bag that it gave in. Like, I know this should fit in here, but screw it, throw it in the garage. It's not gonna matter. I'll need it until next year anyways. If I wear a 3XL slim fit shirt, that means it's gonna fit me when I go to work, but not after I go to Chipotle for lunch. Some of these buttons aren't gonna make it. I'm gonna have to wear a tie the rest of the day. Yeah, bad guys invented ties, I hope you guys know that. Necessity, the mother of invention, they're like, I can't even button all these buttons. I'm just gonna wrap this piece of silk around my neck. I can use it as a napkin later. Genius! You're welcome. You're welcome. Here's a weird thing. I still have a day job. I'd love to be doing comedy full time, but my parents just don't have that kind of money, right? So I work for a beer distributor, which is weird, I guess. I don't know, but everybody's got to do something. I don't know. Not all the doctors have cancer. I don't know if that makes sense. That's not a great analogy, but it makes me feel better. So I work in an office, which is fun, but I also get to go out and go to stores, which is also entertaining. I don't know if anybody's been to a plaid pantry lately. Yeah, it's like a fucking refugee camp out there. It is entertaining. I found a one-up from plaid pantries. There's these places in Tillamook, Oregon called Center Markets. Have you ever been to a Center Market? It's a joy. It's a real joy. I pulled up at a Center Market a couple weeks back. It was about 8:30 in the morning. There's a guy in the very front parking spot in front of the double doors doing whippets in his car. Right? Not out of a ready whip can whippets. You guys know what whippets are. Come on. I saw the NA hands go up. You guys know what whippets are. When you suck the nitrous out of a can of ready whip. But this guy's he's got the whole Starbucks canister apparatus, like the whole fancy thing you've got to screw the little things into. I was just like, oh man, this guy's really getting after it for 8:30 in the morning. And then I see a car pull in, I'm like, oh, he's gonna stop now, I'm sure. And the people got out of the car and they were just like, oh, hey, good morning, Ted. He could have worked there for all we know. There's just he's still there hey, good morning, nice to see you, welcome to Tillamook. We're doing whippets at 8:30. need some more duct tape to fix my bumper on my car. Same store, but a half hour later, there's like 9 people in line to get their morning coffee, and I'm in there stacking cases. This lady walks up, I guess I describe her as like cracky, right? Like not scary enough to be a tweaker, but definitely like on something, you didn't want to talk to her. And she walks up in front of this whole crowd of people, and there's this like Lay's potato chip display, but the new weird flavors. And she picks up this bag of Lay's potato chips, that's like biscuits and gravy, and announces to like no one and everybody all at the same time, "Don't eat these! They taste like asshole." What are you gonna do with that information? Then there was this like one old guy in the back of the line who just like shrugged and went up and got a bag, right? He's like, "Yeah, I haven't tasted a butthole since college, right? I mean, $1.99, that's the cheapest butthole you're probably ever gonna..." "You're welcome, sir." I think that was Ted's girlfriend the whole time, I don't know. Center Markets. It's good fun. So we'll do some sober guy jokes. As of March 25th, so it's almost, I'm coming up on 2.5 years, no drinks, no drugs. That's pretty good. Yeah, pretty good about that. I feel like I went out on top though, I did it the right way. Like Peyton Manning, you know, like you win the championship and you walk away from the game. My last drunk started on a Wednesday in Las Vegas, Nevada, and ended the following Tuesday in my front yard in Beaverton. Pretty good. And my neighbor standing over me like, "Dude, are you all right?" Like, no, I was not all right. Some people can't handle Vegas, right? You heard that? This fucking guy. This guy couldn't handle Vegas, yeah. The only problem with that is I also couldn't handle, like, Bowling Green, Ohio, Wilmington, Delaware, Richland, Washington, Eugene, Oregon, Santa Fe, New Mexico, Fresno, California. I got kicked out of a lot of places, is what I'm saying. Don't blame Vegas for my shitty behavior. I quit drinking, which felt pretty good. I don't know, I had a sponsor early on, like when you get those cravings of drink, you tell me, if you feel like you want to have a drink, go have a chocolate milkshake. Right? I can get down with that. If you still want to have a drink, go have another chocolate milkshake. Yeah. And if you still want to have a drink after 2 chocolate milkshakes, then fucking drinking ain't your problem, man. That's what they told me. So now I go to Overeaters Anonymous. Which is true, actually. I do like that program. Here's a quick side note about Overeaters Anonymous. They have a little, like, daily reflection book. Yeah? It's not, like, programmed, like, the little... There's little quotes in it that are just from random people throughout history. Right? Little inspirational quotes. The one yesterday was literally from Francis Bacon. What the hell are you trying to do to me here, Overeaters Anonymous? Like, I'm sitting there reading it, like, doing my morning meditation. They're like, "Oh, shit, bacon sounds good. We should get some bacon." All day down the tubes, man. I was mad at them for that. That's all right. That's good stuff. I do love some bacon. It's true. I don't know. I've done a lot of weird things to try to like lose weight, like just be healthier, which is awful. Like about October last year, I decided I was a vegan, which is weird. Yeah, I caught it from a guy I work with. I was just sitting there eating a ham sandwich one day, and the guy in front of me was like, "Think about their faces, dude." And I was like, "Oh man, I can't eat this. This is ruined." So yeah, a vegan. Yeah, that's weird. I feel like overnight I became the world's fattest vegan. Which is strange. Like people don't believe you. You look like this. I was here in Portland, I ordered a vegan burrito from a place, and this guy was like, "Does she want onions on it?" I'm like, "I don't know who you're talking to. It's for me." And he was like, "Oh, well, do you want sour cream on it? I won't tell anybody." I was like, "No! Try not to be so fat all the time, man. Help me out here. I had to tell my dad I was a vegan. When you become vegan, weird things like that happen. Yeah, like we're sitting in a restaurant, I go like, Dad, I gotta tell you something. He like puts his fork down, he's like, what? I was like, I'm a vegan now. He kind of sighed real deep and was like, well, I'm just glad your grandpa's not alive to see this. I'm like, what? It's not something you say on dietary choices. Like, I didn't kill anybody. Jesus. Miss Kahoot Tanner. Yeah. I don't know. I knew I had to make better life choices as far as like what I was eating and obviously stopping drinking. I don't know if this happens to you guys, like you fart in your sleep? Right? But have you ever farted in your sleep and it smelled so bad that it registered in the dream that you were having and became part of your subconscious reality? Because that's some Inception shit right there, like. If Leonardo DiCaprio walks up to you in your dream and is like, dude, did you crap your pants? Like, you start rethinking what you're doing with your body. That's what you need to do. Yeah. Like, no, I'm just blaming it on the dog. I don't know. Like, what do you do? Man, I go to the gym a little bit. Not really. That's just the purpose of this joke. I go to the gym. I do have a gym membership in Beaverton. It's like Crunch or Boom or Snap or Pow or one of those stupid onomatopoeic names. Why do all the gyms sound like bones breaking? Like, that doesn't, that's not a place I want to go. Just call it Ouch. That'd be better. I just made that up. That was pretty good. So the gym I go to, you walk in and there's like locker rooms, and then you have to go up two flights of stairs to get to where the goddamn stairmasters are. Like, no, that's asinine. I'm not doing that. I'm gonna go up there once. I'm gonna come back down. I'm gonna need a cigarette. I'm gonna go stand out front, figure out how to burn this place to the goddamn ground. If you incite it, Todd, your stupid polo shirt, your spiky hair, I hate your fucking guts. I hate the gym. I had a membership in like King City, and it was like there was never any parking. You don't walk 2 miles. No, I need a shuttle bus to get me to the gym so I can go sit on the treadmill. Stupid. I just want to watch Sports Center. You can just do that at my house now. I hate the gym. What's the point of that? Oh, what else has been going on? It's been nice lately, though, right? We feel good about the nice weather. Is it too hot for everybody? No, you were good, yeah. All right, good. Anybody else, like, is a seasonal affected? You know, you get sad when the sun doesn't come out for a long time? You should fucking move. That's what you should do, right? Yeah. I know, I feel the same way. Yeah, drugs, yeah. I would move to San Diego, but I was born without skin pigment. I don't know if you can see that here. But I am see-through. I can't eat medium salsa. I don't need to go where it's 100 degrees every day of the year. A couple more stories in here. Oh yeah, so I do. I like driving around in my beer truck, which is fun. Yeah, it's a good time. I got my little van. I roll the windows down, crank the radio. You guys like the oldie songs? You probably just call them songs, ladies. All right, fine. Just kidding. You guys are fine. My favorite song came on the radio the other day. It's called In the Summertime by Mungo Jerry. You guys know that song? It's a great song, right? Until you get to that second verse, which is, the words are, if her daddy's rich, take her out for a meal. If her daddy's poor, just do what you feel. Wait, what? Have a drink, have a drive, go out and see what you can find? Who wrote this song? Ted Kennedy? Unacceptable behavior, Mungo Jerry. Don't treat ladies like that anymore. It's a date rape anthem, 1973. Mungo to prison with that kind of attitude, Mungo Jerry. Yeah, I don't drink and drive anymore. That feels pretty good. It wasn't even court ordered. I'm just a fucking hero. Yeah. Drink it in, folks. Now that I don't drink, though, like, I have dreams. Like, not like goals and shit, obviously. No, but like movies in your head while you're asleep. Yeah, if you don't get blackout drunk every night, you remember your dreams, and they can be kind of fun. Any lucid dreamers here? Anybody have lucid dreams where you know you're in a dream, you can do whatever you want? Yeah, I'm not going to pick on you, that little halfway. I also have lucid dreams, and mine are stupid. I'll tell you about my most recent lucid dream. I sat on my couch in my underwear and watched SportsCenter and ate cereal. Right? I woke up, I was like, that was an awesome dream. I was like, that was also what you were going to do today. Like, that was my whole to-do list, and I just wasted a dream on it. Like, I could have flown. I could have made out with my sister-in-law and gotten away with it. I could have made out with my brother-in-law and gotten away with it, right? It's a dream. People, it's 2016.